In this tutorial, we will try to explain step by step how to make and use the layer mask in MS Paint with all its features. To get the most out of this training, following this content and our previous and subsequent or other related trainings that we publish in series will help you understand and achieve much more. We open MS Paint and start with a clean and blank canvas with a white background color. In this tutorial, we create an example of a gradient background from red to yellow in flame tones to help you understand the content more easily. If you want to learn more, you can watch our gradient tutorial. As we mentioned earlier, in fact, MS Paint does not have a separate layer feature like Photoshop, GIMP, or Krita. Here, we will only try to implement the layer logic in the most primitive and simple way on MS Paint in alternative ways. Working layer by layer will provide us with great convenience and manageability in our drawing and painting and masking. In a sense, we can think of this background design gradient color as layer 1 or layer 2 if we count the white background. We minimized and made a copy of the red to yellow gradient layer we created and then inverted its colors. And if you notice, we have another example of a blue-toned gradient. We set the background color of the empty part of our canvas as black to create a mask. To create a mask, it is enough to use two contrasting colors. The important thing is that these two contrasting colors do not mix as much as possible with the surface to be applied. You can also use green, pink, or any shade of gray. Since we are going to create a mask with a black background color, we need to use white shapes and lines. And of course, it is important that our second color, the overall background color, is white. Another very important issue is that area selection is done in a transparent manner. For demonstration purposes, we created a group of mask shapes from primitive ready-made shapes, selected them with transparent selection, and applied them to gradient colored surfaces as a mask layer. We have explained this process in the previous training content about decoupage and background removal. If you have not watched it, we strongly recommend you to watch it. Now we have expanded our canvas area from the side to create a more complex mask shape. We will create a simple flame image, make it into a mask layer, and apply it as a mask layer on gradient surfaces. We apply our masks in different sizes and scales, and on different gradient color surfaces. The layer mask application you create here is limited by your imagination and design skills. In our text training content, we have presented examples of layer mask application. In a sense, we can create different designs with a text mask that we will create again over the gradients we have created here. Of course, we can also create a more complicated layer mask. For example, we could create a triangular mask with a gradient blue flame icon inside and another design applied on a red background. As mentioned earlier, the layer mask application you create here is limited by your imagination and design skills. Finally, we summarize all this work by collecting our canvas. Yes, we have come to the end of this training content. If you haven't seen it, we recommend you to watch the previous and subsequent trainings of the series. We will continue the series with more beautiful trainings, and we will be with you again very soon. Don't forget to subscribe and click the bell to receive notifications for new videos. See you again soon, and thanks for watching.